this session, I'm going to demonstrate how to use citations and bibliography and managing sources for references in a document. This is a very powerful tool, and I strongly suggest that if you're a student anywhere, take advantage of this. This tool allows you to insert sources of information for a book or article or other material where it came from. And then as you're utilizing it for multiple papers, it also builds a repository of the source resource manager stuff within your master list here. Let's say this is something that we are citing. So let's assume we copied this and now we want to cite it. You first have to determine what your style of writing is, whether it's APA or MLA. So I'm going to pick at this point APA. Basically, you just have to do this once for all your papers or for that course or whatever you're for that document. And then you click here on Insert Citation. You could insert an existing one or you add a new source. So in this case, let's say it's a book. And the author here, you could click on Edit or you can simply type it here. You enter the title of the author, and then you put the year when it was published, the city, and then the publisher as well. You could also insert here additional fields if you needed to, as to what volume it is, the number of volumes, the title, pages, and so on. Then you click OK. Notice for the APA style, this is how you would cite this source. Last name, comma, 2016. Now we go to another part of the document, and let's assume that this was another section that we want to cite. We put in parentheses, and now we go here under citation, and then add a new source. Notice that under the new source, you can pick other things as well. So for example, you could pick a journal article, you could pick a periodical, a conference, or a report, a website, a recording, and so on. All of these are the small technicalities that are complicated to remember, but this is a tool that makes it easy for you how to cite it. So for example, an article from a website, you could simply click to a document from a website, and you put in the author. Notice you also have examples here. So in this case, we are going from to the web. So we go here to the website, and let's say this is the article, Can Laws Keep Up with the Tech World? And it was written and published on such and such a date. So now the author in this case, it would be Bruce Schneier. And then we go to our document, and then we'll just put the author in there. The name of the web page is the title of the article. The name of the website, so this would be, for example, cnn.com. The year, 2015. So actually, we want to put the year in there, the date that it was published. So notice it was updated on November 21st, 2015. So we put here year 2015, the month, December, and then the day, 21. And then you also need to put in there the URL for this article. So we copy it, and then we'll paste it in there. And then we simply click OK. And it's good to go at this stage. Now, let's say that somewhere else, now notice I'm going up in my document here. Let's say that this is my other section that I want to cite. And now, let's assume that I'm simply citing this for now. I can go ahead and click here on Insert Citation, and I could even pick an existing citation. Now, notice here under Manage Sources, I used two of them in this document, those that have the check marks. Those were new ones that I just entered. But basically, this is a list of other sources that I have done other research, for example, this first one. Now, what I could do is I could utilize this in my document here, in my paper. So all I have to do is I go here under Insert Citation and pick that source to be included. Now, let's suppose that I'm done with all my citations for this paper, and now I want to insert the bibliography or the works cited. Go here to my document and insert a new page. I go and insert, let's say, a page break or whatever. Basically, I'll just do a page break for now. And now on the next page, I want to insert the bibliography. I go under References, and then I click on Bibliography. And notice it gives you multiple options here. You have Bibliography, References, and Works Cited. That will depend on the type of research that you are doing and what your paper or professor requires. So for example, if I wanted Bibliography here, here is my Bibliography. And it has the word Bibliography. By the way, it's putting everything also alphabetically, automatically, and it's formatting and italicizing and doing all that redundant work automatically for you.